we'll be back into our third video on Python, you know, with Flask. By the way, I was carrying actually Flask on my hand, then actually to fall down and it broke, my friend. So really looking for where I go and get the money and I buy another Flask and fix it, because when my daddy comes home and find me without a Flask, I think they won't just cut my head. Okay, now maybe on the other way to cut the story short, my friend, you guys, if you haven't subscribed to my YouTube channel, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Support me, man. Support me, my friends. I love you guys. Support me too. Okay, and you guys are watching from Facebook page, please, you guys who are watching my videos from my Facebook page, please make sure you guys, you have this in your mind. In this video, basically we are going to look into how can we actually add many HTML pages inside your Python Flask website or mobile app. How do you on web app? How do you add those multiple pages? How do you add those pages into your Flask page? Now, like, just you can see this. This is what some of you guys remember saying, that on the next video I'll be definitely sharing this. Now, this is our home page. As you can see, this is the home page. Blah blah blah, having some blah blah data there. So I'm just going to right click there, try to shake around whether I have you had stuff. So I'm just going to say, call this home page, blah blah blah. Maybe this home page, yeah, blah blah. Yes, that's it. This is our home page. As you can see, this is our home page. And on the other way around, for me to go to the second page, I'm just going to give a first slash there and I put about now. And when I hit about, I think you can see I'm just in about me or about page. About page. Get this is about page. About page, not about us. Okay. So definitely, if you try to cross check that, yes, I think you can see my stuff is running as normal. So the script is picking all those stuffs, and I think you can see the Python is rendering that thing by python-home.py. So that's definitely less, and as you can see, we have this down in our page. Now let's see on this part. Now, how are we going to add those people in our page? How are we going to add another page? This is very short, some kind of video. I'm just going to use some means. Now, if I just going to cut this down off, let me break this off first, because I'm not going to use this very video. So I'm going to just stop this page from running. So like that. So if you try to check right now on this page, we should have page without, which is not running at all. So that's it. And this, if you try to cross check, we have nothing there in our page. So let me just try to add it from the other previous page. This is the page we are going to check. So I'm just going to call this one to be our home page if possible, so that we can always find a way around, so that we can get that thing. So I'm going to simply say home page. Let this be our first page. The thing I'm going to do now is to call for this lib or first py that blah blah blah. So when I hit enter, I think it's going to generate for us that first page. I think you can see it's launching the page, it's activating the debug is activated and the page is loaded. I think you can see. Wow, it's trying to say two pages. This looks funny. Now, sorry, it's because I just happened to have the other stuff on our page. So I just need to do this. I need to do this. To make cut story short. Okay. I'm just going to move this off. So, I'm just going to do that. I'm going to just come in here and I say maybe home page. I think that's good for now. I think it's good. So, So I think you can see this is a home page. This is our home page, man. So, if that's our home page, what are we going to do now? We are going to now look onto how to create about page. Because now, if you touch it, if I happen to give a false slash for now and I say I got about like that, we cannot get it, which is telling us not found. So how do you fix up the about page using the Python to code that part of? Now, things simple. What I'm going to do is just create up a simple another page. I need to define another function inside our Python struct. So inside the templates, create up a new page file, sorry, and you save it as about. So this is going to be about. Now about.html, because we are rendering up an HTML page within our pages. So this is the about page. So I'm just going to drop up the link of this page, whatever I have in this page. I'm just going to fix it here down on about page. Now I'm kind of lazy enough for now, so I'm going to just change this one to about page. So I hope that's going to be good for now. Facebook blah blah, then I'm going to just leave this one as about page. something like that. So really about us, maybe about us. Oh, sorry, I'm just gonna say about us. Maybe we really love maybe programming with you. No, this OSP Pro. No, so I love you guys, love programming with you guys. That's it. Now if you cross check again on our page, if you try to render, that's good. So if you try to run the page, good. But if you happen to go back on first slide, give assumption to say about page, we cannot get it still. Why? It's because that page is not rendered the other side. So how are we going to render that page inside this page? Remember, this is our home page, and if you try to cross check, this is the home page you rendered here. But now we need to find out how do we really fix up that error into our page here. Now the next thing to do is, this is what you are going to do. Let me try to do it. You just try to copy this piece of line of code. I'm going to just paste it in here, and I'm just going to comment down here, and I try to say adding one on us about page, or maybe adding more pages. So this is how they add more pages. You define more functions within your Python script or within your Python page. So this is how I'm going to add this page. So I'm just going to first remove this off from our page here. So that's it for now. So if you try to cross check, this is it was hello. I'm just going to check this one to home to be as if it is okay for, you know, for simple readability of that page which is going to be rendered. And then this gone, I'm just going to call it as about, you know, to be about us page, you know, to be about like that. Then inside here, I'm just going to define a function which is going to be about. Now inside there, when I say defining up that given function, okay, and calling up for that route as that switch which is going to be serving us that that page, new page called about.html, which is going to be this page around here. So it's going to be rendering us that page, and by the end of the day we should be finding up that page popping for us on the screen. That implies as someone gives a forward slash on that given page, we should be having now a one on us about.html or about page, which is going to be rendered as about page. That implies we don't need that extension of .html being rendered for us on the server. Instead, we shall just be picking up that given page by something called about. That implies in simple terms, if you want to create up another page, okay, before that, let me just try to save this, try to save that, and try to revise our page again. We should find that page popping up on our pages. Hope there's no error. Sorry, hope there's no error. Okay, why is it not working? Let me check that. Sorry, wow, it's trying to tell me detected change in this blah blah line of piece of code. Oh god, okay, existing endpoint function percent at endpoint. Oh, I'll send that value function mapping is overriding an existing endpoint function. Hello, oh god, sorry for that. Now, what I'm just going to try to define that this was the first function I defined, which was called hello, sorry. Then I came down here and I tried to define something called about, which is going to be rendering us what on us about page, and then generating that. So I'm just try to refresh our page again. If I happen to come back again here on our page, try to cross check what have I done wrong. So check that. Oh really, sorry. You pick that again and I see. So if you shake this root about, good. This about.html, this define rendered plate dot. So I think that there's a problem somewhere. So I'm going to just try to do this again and try to run my page. Okay. You know, initially I had some problems and I did some, you know, kind of problem on our page. And that's why it is could bring that kind of error rendering in our page. But it went towards detecting the changes, restarting that transport race move blah blah this on the line 10 on root dot. Let's check whether it has to have that error anymore. So I'm going to refresh this page and I think that's it. That's for now. I think last time I made some change in the function. I changed the function called the hello and I gave it home. So here I'm going to give false light and I say about, and I think you can see now, about page is working as expected, because I was like, why is not working out? So this is it. So this is going to be about page, about us page, which can be easily rendered in PHP, or sorry, in Python script, as you can see now. So my friends, for now, that's what I can say. So in a simple term, you can actually generate more pages. So I may just simply say contact us page. So I can really create another page here, and I called maybe contact us.html. So this contact us.html, it generates the same page around here. If I just paste that page around here and try to change this page as contact page, so I'm going to simply change this one to maybe contact page, contact us page. So if they are to contact us, maybe, you know, we have expect their form, so I'll simply say this is where our, maybe I'm going to just make it a simple term, maybe click here to view or to contact us. But I'm indefinite, I'm not creating up a link or where people can pick me or reach me. Or let me just click there and say maybe click here. But in simple terms, this is not how they write Python stuff with the Flask. I'm going to show you that one in the next video. For now, if you touch cross check and try to render that bigger page, we're not going to get anything, because not actually adding our page. So like I told initially, you just need to add multiple lines of code on down on our page. So I'm just going to come back down on a page here, and I'm just going to add something called contact. I'm just going to generate a page called the contact, like that. So that in a simple term, contact, contact. So that in a simple term, contact is going to be rendering up on this page called contact -us.html, which is this page here. So if you can cross check that page and try to check around this page here, this is the page we have. So I'm just going to copy that page and try to work on that page here in our pages here. So the main page, which is going to be generating and rendering up all those scripts for us. So I think you can see we're just copying up this, but this is not the best way of programming. You guys have ever programmed with me, this is not how the best way of programming. So we shall be customizing up our pages, our codes later on, and I'll show you how to code, how to add your own CSS, instant templates, how to add all those stuff. But for now, if you try to cross check our page, I hope it's going to be working as well. Expected now, it may not work out that, because let me check that again and find out why. So this contact us, this is that. So statistically it changes, so I need to refresh the page from here. Remember, the debug is enabled, so I have no problem. Expect that to pop up for me. It's telling me there's no end on this page. Which line is that detecting changes? It's starting near line 14 on modules on Flask. Line 14 is rendering up contact. Which contact is contact? This one page. So in a simple term, what I'm going to be doing here, this contact -html. So if I try to refresh here, we should not get anything. We hope to get nothing here, because we said there's nothing rendered here in this page. So what I'm going to do now is to come back again on my page, try to render it again, so that we can find the best way out. Oh, sorry, it's telling me more problem around there. Shake that again. Let me check line 14 and I find out why. So if you look on line 13, this is it, line 10. This line 14, contact. Let me just try to change this, because I don't want what brings from a lot of issues for now. Don't want to take a lot of time on this video. I'm just going to change this one to that, to contact. And then I'm going to just come back here and try to move this one off for now, so that I don't have much problems. So here we are rendering up this page. And this one here, we are rendering up one known as the first page, which is home.html. And then if I try to come back again on my page here, if I try to come back again, hope it's going to work now. Try to click play again and try to work out why it's not working. View function mapping is override an existing default function about. Wow. So and find out why it's not work giving me what I need. It's saying it's overriding. So I need to first give it some time as it finishes up. It's over. Oh, sorry. Guys, I'm sorry. I think here I forgot the function. Sorry. I was like even getting confused. What's wrong? What's going on? You know, this should be a different page. This is called contact. This can be a home. Get? That's how the thing is like. So this is a different function. This is a different function. I'm really sorry for that. I was really confused. I was actually trying to think what's going on. What's really the heck's going on? But thanks to God, I think I handled that. I think I've mastered most of that. You know, my brain was also trying to be hanging up. Now I need to take some water so that I can push my brain to think wisely. You know. So, but I'm sorry for that, guys. It was actually trying to take me a lot of time, but God has been so gracious, we are good to us that we have fixed that error without wasting a lot of time. So if you try to cross check again back on our page, we should already have the page already rendered to us. If again you come back on our page and give us slash about, we should be definitely going to about page. And the same time, if you also happen to go back on our page and type contact page or contact, you should find us taking us to contact, and when you click there, it would be definitely would have been linking us to another page. But I say this is not the right way how we create up a link in Python. It's not the right way you create up a link, but definitely would take us to another page. So my guy friends, I really have to appreciate you guys. I thank you all guys for supporting me. You guys have subscribed to my YouTube channel. This is how you actually add more pages in Flask and Python using the HTML pages in Flask and Python. So if you find this video interesting, please don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Please guys, I need your support. So I wish you a nice time. Thank you guys. Stay safe and don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. If maybe you're from Uganda and really want to learn Python with me, come to OSP IT Digital Solutions. We are located in Wandege in the Diamond Trust Bank building. We are in the second floor. So you definitely can come in on our platform, I mean on our at OSP, and then you get chance to do this. Thanks to God, and thank you guys, especially Team University, who has actually found very good use of OSP, who has even brought the certificates, diploma, and bachelor's under OSP. So if you want to do bachelor's, you want to do certificate course, IT courses with us, you want to come up and do maybe diploma course with us, just come to OSP IT Digital Solutions. All Team University courses are now given to OSP. So you can actually come to OSP and then you pick any course of your choice. And for us, we are giving it out at cheap price because we practice, we train them ourselves. So you guys, come in and then be part of OSP and part of Team University. So may God bless you all. Love you all. Thank you next time. Love you all. Thank you.